Good morning. My name is George Lambert, and I am the recently appointed President and CEO of the Greater Washington Urban League. I'm delighted to welcome you, and thank you for being here this morning. Let me begin by just telling you a little bit about the Greater Washington Urban League. Greater Washington Urban League is a social service civil rights organization. Our mission is to increase the economic and political empowerment of African Americans and other minorities. Moreover, our mission is to help all Americans share equally in the responsibilities and rewards of full citizenship. That said, this press conference is about a victory for the residents of the District of Columbia. Progress is not easy, and unfortunately, too often not timely in delivering a safety net for those most vulnerable in our community. But this morning, we are here because the Office of the People's Counsel successfully delivered securing a settlement agreement with an alternative energy supplier. History has taught us that the protection of consumers cannot be safely guarded by casting our fate to the wind and hoping for the best. That is why I believe that this settlement will be a deterrent to future non-compliant behavior. I applaud the Office of the People's Counsel for daring to care for those who are vulnerable in our community, and also oftentimes those who are disenfranchised. I am also delighted that the Office of the People's Counsel have invited the Greater Washington Urban League to partner in administering the Special Energy Assistance Fund. Ladies and gentlemen, it is now my pleasure to introduce Sandra Frye of the Office of the People's Counsel.
Thank you very much, George. Good morning and welcome. Disclaimer, I did not call for the cold weather. But first, I want to thank and acknowledge the Greater Washington Urban League for its sustained and outstanding service over the course of its 75 years of being in the District of Columbia. They have served our community in so many ways and on so many levels. Second, I would like to thank them for partnering with OPC to facilitate our ability to make a meaningful change and to deliver a tangible benefit to DC consumers. Over a year ago, we began to receive complaints from DC consumers regarding alternative energy suppliers that were in their neighborhoods. We heard allegations of misrepresentation, of deceptive pricing, of slamming or unlawful changing of accounts, and other shady business practices. What was really alarming was that they were targeting our senior communities as well as our homebound communities, frequently our most vulnerable, citizens. We immediately filed a petition with the Public Service Commission. We also reached out to city council members, including Council Member Che and Council Member Alexander, both of whom wrote letters to the commission in support. The commission responded quickly and convened a hearing and an investigation. And at that July hearing, we heard 22 individual witnesses provide testimony, and that testimony was emotional, personal, and compelling. At that moment, I knew that I had to do something that was out of the box. If we wanted to really have a meaningful impact on what their concerns were, if we wanted to address and respond to their concerns, if we wanted to make whole the hundreds of consumers who were actually impacted by the activities of these alternative providers. Subsequent to the hearing, we entered into settlement discussions with Starian. As a result of those discussions, we were able to present a settlement agreement to the Public Service Commission. I want to thank the commission for quickly approving it, and as represented by Commissioner Joanne Dowdy Fort today, thank you. They approved it in time for it to be implemented this year during this winter season. The settlement is unprecedented. It provides $100,000 in emergency assistance to low-income residents. As you know, most of the financial resources for energy assistance are exhausted by this time of the year, and energy bills are predicted to increase by as much as 20% due to the colder than usual winter season. Over 300 consumers complained to OPC and the PSC, and each one of them will have their bills recalculated either through a cash credit, The projected value of the reimbursement alone is $68,000. Equally, and if not more important, and this was important to me, the agreement addresses the issues and concerns that are at the heart of consumer complaints, and that is the business practices and procedures of these types of providers. I'm really, really confident that we have set the groundwork for a plan that provides and will create a standard of practice that will prevent the type of complaints that were the genesis for this investigation. We're also, at the same time, sending the message that businesses are welcome if they abide by the rules in DC. Once we signed the agreement, we immediately turned our attention to identifying the DC-based organization that was best suited to receive the funds and conduct the program. Standing out among the many organizations that we contact was the Urban League. It was a bonus that the Urban League had a substantial record of service delivery, specifically in the area of energy assistance, and a staff trained and capable of meeting the administrative requirements of our public-private partnership. It really is my hope and my desire that collaborations such as this will be the norm rather than the exception. As public agencies, regulators, and private companies serving the district, we have a shared public obligation to come together for the common good of our citizens. I have already reached out to the incumbent utilities to do more, and they have been receptive. As you know, Pepco is a regular contributor to GWUL, and Washington Gas administers the WAF fund. What I really want to do is to challenge all of the other providers, as well as the private companies, to come up to the plate. Let them do, they need to do their part in making certain that DC consumers are served and served well. Thank you very much. I am thrilled to be here. I am thrilled to have the opportunity to provide this assistance, which I know will be well used and well administrated by the Urban League. As you know from looking at your agenda, we have invited council members as well as other key stakeholders in this process. At this time, I would like to invite to the podium to say a few words on behalf of Council Member Mary Che, who, as I indicated, initially was one of the council members who actually sent a letter of support to the Public Service Commission. I understand that she's having transportation problems and was unable to make it. However, Devin Barrington Ward is going to come up and say a few words on her behalf.
My name is Devin Barrington Ward, and I serve as the Director of Communications for the Office of Councilmember Mary Che. The councilmember, regrettably, is not able to be here this morning. Ironically enough, the chair of the Transportation and the Environment Committee is having transportation issues and cannot make it here. Normally, she would ride her bike, but it's very cold outside, and I think you guys can understand why she's not here. But the councilmember supported this initiative because she saw the need. So I'm going to read a brief statement on her behalf. In 1999, the district passed the Electric Competition Act, which enabled alternative energy suppliers to begin competing for business with Pepco and each other in an effort to provide additional options to consumers. It was the hope that this would produce improved choices for district consumers in the end. However, some alternative energy suppliers began employing deceptive tactics that intentionally robbed consumers of the opportunity to make an informed choice. When the council member learned of this, she wrote a letter to the Public Service Commission supporting the Office of the People's Council's investigation of the alternative energy suppliers, including Steron Energy. As the chair of the Committee on Transportation and the Environment, Councilmember Che supports fostering a business environment where alternative energy providers can do well and compete for business in the district. However, consumers should always be protected from deceptive practices like switching a consumer's energy provider without true consent or significantly increasing rates without adequate notice. The council member thanks the hard work of Sandra Frye and her team at the Office of the People's Council and of Chairman Betty Ann Kane and Commissioner Joanne Fort of the Public Service Commission. The district has been able to, due to their hard work, the district has been able to reach a settlement that holds Steron Energy accountable for their deceptive business tactics, while at the same time securing a sizable donation to establish an energy assistance fund this upcoming winter that will provide underserved families who may not be able to pay their utility bills this winter with this much needed assistance. And the council member is confident that the Greater Washington Urban League will be able to manage these funds in a responsible, fair, and ethical manner. Thank you all for the opportunity. Thank you all for your hard work. The district appreciates it.
Next, I would like to call committee director for Councilmember McDuffie's camp from Councilmember McDuffie, Ward 5, Ronan Goldstone.
Good morning, everyone, and sorry I'm an add-on to the agenda, but Councilmember McDuffie did want to be here and regretfully could not make it due to a scheduling conflict. But as chair of the Committee on Government Operations, which has oversight over the Office of People's Council and the Public Service Commission, he did want to have a couple words said here. And so the main thing he really wanted was to congratulate Ms. Mattavous-Frye and the Public Service Commission on their hard work here. This is, as Ms. Mattavous-Frye indicated, an unprecedented settlement that we have here today. And it really is in the best interests of the district residents, district ratepayers. And he is just overjoyed to have someone working as hard as Ms. Mattavous-Frye does every day in and day out for district residents. The Public Service Commission and the Office of People's Council really are some of the unsung heroes of district agencies. They really, you don't hear about them on a day-to-day basis, but they really are workhorses plowing through and really affecting district residents' lives every day. And I just think we should all just take a moment really just to applaud Ms. Mattavous-Frye and the Public Service Commission for all their hard work every day. Both Councilmember McDuffie and I are both recovering attorneys, so we both understand a little bit about settlements and litigation and whatnot. And I can tell you, without a doubt, settlement is always preferable to long drawn out litigation. And in this instance, again, the district ratepayers are really coming out with the best outcome here, having a $100,000 donation to a fantastic organization, the Greater Washington Urban League. As Ms. Mattavous-Frye indicated, Mr. Lambert and his team work harder than most in the district, and we are just ecstatic that they will be the ones administering this fund, and we know that it's going to go to help some of our most needy residents. So again, the council member sends his regrets for not being able to make it here, but I just wanted to congratulate everyone involved in this process and echo the words of Council Member Che as well. So thank you.
Again, thank you very much, and please give our regards and appreciation to the hard work of Council Member McDuffie. We also have a representative from Council Member Graham's office. and Mr. Wilson Reynolds. Would you please come and say a few words on his behalf?
Thank you, People's Council. Good morning, everybody. It's great to see you. It's great to be here. It's a great event. As you know, it's a rather busy time at the council right now, which is probably why a lot of our bosses can't be here. This is the time when the performance and oversight hearings begin, which lead us into our favorite fun time of the year, which is this thing called the budget. And right now, the council may want to be here, but right now he's preparing a hearing, which is going to be starting in about 20 minutes, on the in the terminology of the District of Columbia prose. This one's called Homeless Services Reform Amendment Act of 2014. And as you know, homeless services are under attack in this city. We have incredible demand, incredible strain. From all across the border, we're being pressured in so many different directions. Emergency rental assistance for families is being eroded. I don't have to tell you, there's a bunch of friends of ours up on this hill somewhere where they cut the food stamps and created some shortages in people that just need to eat. We have, and our friends here with the Office of People's Council can tell us that our colleagues in the energy businesses have not been bashful about asking for rate increases. So we're feeling these pressures across the board, which is why it's so important and so special and so wonderful that we're here today to announce something and to share in something that's actually going to help the human beings in the District of Columbia. And I want to give you a round of applause on that. It's also telling and fitting and proper that we are standing on this ground. The Urban League has been a leader in this city in these causes in the past. And not only that, and fortunately I'm very glad that this is all happening here in Ward 1, but that's parochial, okay, that's another story. We are within, if I did my count as I was coming over here, within four blocks of four major low-income and senior buildings in Ward 1. This is a target-rich opportunity of the very clients that we live to serve. And we get those calls every day, and you know what I'm talking about. So on behalf of the council member, thank you so much for this good work, and I hope to see you again. Take care.
Thank you, Mr. Wilson, and again, my appreciation to Councilmember Graham. Next, I would like to introduce Commissioner Joanne Darley Fort. I have known Commissioner Fort for many, many years, and I am thrilled that she is now serving our community, the District of Columbia, on the commission. Commissioner Fort, would you say a few words?
Thank you and good morning. As some of you may know, before I joined the commission, I did serve as an outside counsel to the Office of People's Counsel. So if you see me looking very friendly sometimes with members of the Office of People's Counsel, that is why I put that on the record so people can understand. I worked for a law firm that also did outside work for Pepco at one point when I did not do work on Pepco's behalf. So you see me looking friendly with people from Pepco, that's, you know, why. But that's not, you know, so I'm balanced, you know, that's the message. But that's not why I'm here. You know, I'm here because of this great settlement that we have. A previous business commitment outside of the district has kept the chair, Betty Ann Kame, from being here as well. But I know I speak for both of us when I say that we are thrilled to be here to recognize the People's Council for the initiative that she and her office took. I see the other members over here, that they took to bring the complaints to the commission and ask us for an investigation of the activities of the alternative service providers. And as Sandra Mattavous-Frye has said, that resulted in an investigation and a hearing where it was clear that one company in particular, Sterion Energy, was a problem. Both of us want to thank Sandra Mattavous-Frye for the investigation and the resolution. We also want to thank Sterion Energy for its willingness to reach an equitable resolution of the complaints through the settlement process that the commission has both approved and supports. Sterion's contribution to the Greater Washington Urban League for an energy assistance program for low-income consumers in particular is a welcome bonus to that settlement. The program is needed and greatly appreciated, particularly at this time when the weather has been so cold and people are going to see very high bills. The Washington Urban League, the Greater Washington Urban League, like OPC, has deep roots in and experience with the target communities that we are really most concerned about. And so we are thrilled that the partnership has been formed as part of the settlement process. We're sure that the combination of these two organizations will lead to a successful program that will benefit district residents. When the commission approved the settlement agreement, we said, "We are eager to grow," this is a quote, "we are eager to grow the competitive energy supply market in the district, and we welcome new entrants into our market. But growth in the competitive energy market must not be done at the expense of district consumers." We look forward to seeing the results of the voluntary compliance program that OPC and Sterion have committed to put in place to improve Sterion's marketing materials and its solicitation practices. We think it will be a model that other alternative energy suppliers can use. And as we celebrate the contribution to the Washington Urban League that's being made as part of the settlement and the settlement itself, we want the district community to know that the commission will continue to actively monitor the activities of all the competitive energy suppliers who are operating in the district to ensure that their marketing and business practices are in the best interest of district consumers. Thank you for letting me be part of this celebration, and congratulations to both of you.
Thank you very much, Commissioner Ford. I would also like to recognize the presence of Dr. Teresa Lawrence. And I've known Dr. Lawrence for many, many years. She is the director of Deputy Director of Energy at the Department of DDOE, at the DC Department of Energy. And she, as you know, DDOE is directly responsible for the management of LIHEAP funding. So she is very sensitive to the needs of the community with respect to energy bills and other, you know, areas of concern. So thank you, Dr. Lawrence, for coming. Would you like to say a few words?
Thank you, Sandra Mattavous-Frye, and thank you to the Office of the People's Counsel for inviting us here today to celebrate with you in this notable event. On behalf of Keith Anderson, Director of the District Department of the Environment, I would like to commend the Office of the People's Counsel for the insightful use of these funds at this particular time, especially as we are coming through an especially harsh winter heating season. I'd also like to recognize the great work of the Urban League in providing these vital services to so many people and in a vast array of areas. Programs such as these play a vital role in the Mayor's Sustainable DC plan and the Mayor's vision for Sustainable DC, in where one of the main goals is to make the district the greenest, healthiest, and most livable city in the nation. One of the key components of making DC the most livable city involves affordability. As we know, many of our low-income residents cannot afford to pay their electric and gas and other utility bills. And you know, this program plays a key part in addressing that issue, as well as reducing energy burdens. As many of you know, DDOE, as was mentioned a minute ago, provides energy assistance to many of our low-income district residents, but we cannot reach everybody. And programs such as these provide additional resources to many of the affected population. Over the last few years, we have seen cuts, you know, in federal funding, as many programs have also experienced. So again, this program is vitally necessary at this time. So, you know, this is an example, and a very important example of the partnership that can occur between the district government and nonprofit entities. And we applaud the Office of the People's Counsel, and we applaud the Urban League, the Greater Washington Urban League, for making this happen. So we appreciate, you know, this event today, and we just wanted to say thank you.
Thank you very much, Dr. Lawrence. At this time, I am thrilled to present the $100,000 donation to Mr. Lambert on behalf of the Urban League. But before we do that, I'd like my staff to stand up and be acknowledged. I have received a lot of appreciation and recognition, but clearly it is the work of my staff. They did the yeoman's task of making this happen, and I would like them to stand up so that you'll know who they are. Would you please stand just for a moment? If I don't say it often enough, thank you. And one little last add, in selecting the Urban League, you know, we looked at a number of different organizations, and one of my staff members, you know, cornered me. There's no way that you can give it to anyone except the Urban League. And that was Linda Jefferson. So I want to thank her. Again, at this time, I do have the honor of presenting the check to Mr. Lambert.
These kind of press conferences. Okay, well, again, thank all of you again. Thank all of the partners. Thank our elected and appointed officials that are here, and good morning to all of you.